The brain is the most complex structure in the universe. There are countless questions about how it functions, such as how human consciousness works. The idea of consciousness remains as a quantum process. So not only does this branch in life science, but as well as physics. Have you ever heard of the fight or flight response? The response is technically a...
We interrupt our program to bring you this important message.
At that moment, you might have jumped in your seat a little bit. If you didn't, that means I didn't scare you enough. In response to acute stress, your body's sympathetic nervous system is activated by the sudden release of hormones. When you get frightened, your heartbeat quickens, and you begin to breathe faster. Your whole body becomes tense, and you're getting ready to take some action. When you get scared, your body has two different responses. You can either run away or flight, or you can fight back. Quantum consciousness is at its play. This associates with many theories of the mind, specifically the holonomic brain theory. It states that human consciousness is formed by quantum effects in or between brain cells. It occurs in fiber neural webs. Joseph Fourier, a scientist from the late 1700s, initiates a series of frequencies called the Fourier transform. Yes, big surprise, he names it after himself. The theory concludes that the process is composed of local field potentials and is windowed by the Fourier transform. Sensory perception is the basis of this theory. The eye of this concept is the eye itself. Take a look at this image, for example. At this moment, the form of this image is transformed by the retina, which is here, and into a quantum process, which is then entered into your visual cortex, here, and your brain recognizes it. This theory, thought by Carl Brebaum and David Bohm, is based on evidence that the dendritic receptive fields in sensory cortexes are described as Gaber functions in mathematical terms. Dendrites play a significant role in the mind. My friend Jeffy here will explain.
A dendrite is a short-branch extension of a nerve cell. Along with impulses received from other cells at synapses are transmitted to the cell body. The axon of the nerve cell creates energy impulses to help keep the cell moving. The energy creates proof that the quantum mind theory is correct. It's like an energy company. Maybe we can call it Axon Mobile.
These dendrites have dendritic receptive fields. These fields are like the sorting hat dividing each student into different houses. The dendritic properties determine the neuron's functional receptive fields based on the processing of visual signals in the area.
We all might as well have a quantum mind.
And of course, there are many questions out there waiting to be solved. But some of the most important ones are right here, in the brain.